Okay, guys, dear viewers of Mtatuzi TV, welcome again to your favorite channel. Today we are going to discuss a mathematics subject. This and the subject or the subtopic we are going to discuss here is concerning with place value. So today we are going to see place value of numbers. So first of all, let us define what is a place value. Place value is just position of digit. Place value is position. Position of digits. Of digits in a given number. So in a given number, so the position of digit in a given number is called the place value. So in any number that you know, any number has digits, and when I say digits, I mean this one. For example, in 21, here there are digits. You put here comma and then you count number of digits. This one is digit number 1. This one is digit number 2. So as you go higher, as the number is bigger, then the number of digits increase. This one is 21. For example, 1. 1 has only one digit, and that's why it is called 1, because the digit of number 1 or place value of 1 is only once, so therefore it has only one digit. But when you say 10, 10 has two digits. The first one is once and the second one is tens. That's why it is called tens. So now, how to identify this digit only in a given number? For example, let us start from 1. Let us start from 1, from 10, 11. Let us start from 11. Because when you say 1, the place value of 1 is only once. Once. 1 has only one place value, and its place value is called once. That's why it is called 1. So for 10 or 12, let us put 12 here. For 12 has two digits. This one is digit number 1 and this one is digit number 2. So the place value of each digit in 12, we are starting identifying place value of digit starting from right to left, starting from right to left, starting from this side, from this number to this side. So we are starting identifying the digits. So this one is, this first digit here is called ones, you see, and this one is called tens. This one is called tens. We put s at the end, not 10, we say tens. Tens. This one is tens. You see? So 12 has two place value, which is ones and tens. So when we go to 100, like this one, we put 100 here, 101. 101 has, first of all, you have to identify the digit on a given number. What are the digits? How many digits 101 have? 101 has only three digits. This one is digit number 1, number 2, number 3. So there are three digits. So what are the place value of which digit is starting from right to left? So we are starting identify this one. It is called ones. You see, this one is ones, and this one, it is called tens. You see, and this one, the last one, this digit is called hundreds. Hundreds. Let me put it right. Hundreds. Hundreds. we write like this, hundreds. We put yes. So these are the digits on 101. So this is how to identify place value of digit on numbers. So now let us take this one. For example, we are given now one, this number. How many digits are there? There are four digits. So the any number with four digits, this is called 1000. So what's 1000 to this one? 1250. 1250. So what are the place value of each digit on 1250? So we are starting identifying the place value of each digit in this number. So the first one, this one is called ones as usual. This one is called ones as usual. This one is ones. The second one, this one. This one is tens. Tens. The place value of 5 there is tens. And the place value of number 2 there is hundreds. 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 It's hundreds, that's why we say 200s. And the last digit there is thousands. This one, the last digit, the place value of this last digit is thousands. Thousands, you see? This one is thousands. So these are the to identify the place value. This is how to identify place value of digit on any given number. For example, maybe let me give you another number. This one maybe number with 5 digits. For example, this one. You see, this one, this number. First, in order to identify the place value, first of all, you need to identify the number of digit. How many digits it has, that number? So this number has 5 digits. Digit number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5. So now let us identify the place value of each digit. Each digit. What is the name of the digit? What is the name of that digit in that position? What is the name of that digit in that position? So therefore, starting from right to left, we say this one, as usual, is what? Once the digit on the right side is ones, and this one is tens, tens, and this one, after tens, it follows what? This one is, this digit there is hundreds, hundreds, hundreds. We put S at the end of the hundred. So we add S only on hundreds, and another digit, this one as usual, this one is what? Thousands, thousands, thousands. We put S. And the last one, and the last digit is, what is the place value of this last digit is, we say 10, 10 what? 10 thousands, 10 thousands. So that's why, only reading it, why do we need to identify this place value? Because if you don't know place value of the digit on a given number, you will not be able to read that number. So that's why in order to read it correctly, you need to know the place value of each digit. For example, this number, how can we read this one after knowing the place value of each digit? So this one, we divide into three. We separate into three digits. 1, 2, 3. So this one. we see there is 12 and 150. So therefore we say, how do we read this one? We read as follows. This one is 12. We're starting with this one. For example, this one, if you group it together, you will get 1 and this one, 0, 0, 0. So this 12 there is a digit of thousands. So how do we read it? We read as follows. What thousands are there? How many thousands are there? These are 12. 12,000. So we say 12,000. 12,000. 12,000. Comma here represent end. 12,000. Not end. We say 12,000. And this one. After hiding this one, you just need, after reading 12,000. You say 12,000. And then what other number that fall after 12,000 is 150. So therefore, we say 12,150. You see? So if you know place value of digit on a given number, you will know to read that number correctly. So therefore, it is very important to understand the place value of each digit on a given number. So for example, this one, we say, how do we read this number? This one we don't separate because it's, so there are only three digits. So we say, we need to identify the place value for this one. This one is hundreds, and this one is tens, this one is ones. So we say 100, 100. When we read, we don't add S at the end of the words. We say 100, 100, 100. This zero represents end. 101, 101. So when, remember, when you are reading a number, you don't add S as if you are writing a place value. So this is mistake. Some people they make mistake when they write a number, they write a numero in number in words. When they write a given numero in words, they just add S as if they are writing the place value of that digits. No, we don't identify digits here. So the place value will help you to read the number correctly. So therefore, for example, this one is, we say 21. This one is 21. Why is 21? Because there are only two digits, and any number with two digits, it has a place value of hundreds, tens. So this one is ones, and this one is tens. How many tens are there? Two. So therefore, we say 20. How many tens are there? There are two, and they're in the place value of tens. So two is in the place value of tens. When you take two times tens, you get 20, and plus this one, you'll get 21. So that's why we say 21. Is that clear? So now I think you have understood concerning the place value of number. Let me give you a quiz. The quiz is this one. Identify the place value of this number. And read it. Identify the place value of this number and read it. The last one is this one. Oh, let me put this one. So you need to identify the place value of which digit and read that number correctly. So place value will help us to read the number correctly. So thank you very much and have a nice day. If you have liked the subject, make sure you subscribe and share this video to your friends so that they can get this knowledge. Thank you and have a nice day.